Hey everyone, thanks for stopping by my channel. Today I'm so happy and excited to be guest designing for Sunny Studio. In today's video, I take you to an enchanted forest where you will meet fairies that can turn butterflies into other fairies, and also we are going to meet a super cute frog. But before moving on to the cards, I just wanted to share with you those three lovely tags I made using three fairies from the Garden Fairy stamp set and the scalloped circle mat 1 to create those tags. So next to the interactive fairy card, let's check out the stamp sets I used on this card. Garden Fairy, seasonal trees for the tree trunk, leaves and flowers. Savannah Safari for some small rocks. Tropical Scenes for the jungle leaves and vines. And Spring Scenes for the small butterfly. So as always, I stamped all my images on 80-pound Nina Solar White cardstock using Memento Tuxedo Black ink. I used the coordinating dies to cut them all and my alcohol markers to color everything. Once all my images were colored, I moved on to the background and started by inking a 5.5 by 4.25 inches Bristol panel. Started with anti-clean and distress ink that I applied all over my panel to get a nice and even base. Next, I added some Modlon distress ink on the edges and at the top. And I blended the colors using my anti-clean blending tool again. Next, I did the same routine as usual, which is adding texture, so I first splattered water droplets all over the paper. I also added more contrast by mixing some anti-clean and some Modlon distress inks with water. Next, I moved on to the interactive part of my card using the Magic Picture Changer die set by Lanfon. I cut a long panel for the pocket die and a short one for the moving piece die. Both papers are Strathmore Bristol cardstock, and I marked the windows using a pencil. I placed the long panel in my Misty tool and stamped a butterfly twice to get a nice impression. And next, on the short panel, I stamped a fairy. Off screen, I cut masks using the coordinating dies and placed them on top of the images. And I also colored the backgrounds using anti-clean and created the same texture as before. I peeled off the masks and then colored the fairy and the butterfly. And I know that I used Strathmore Bristol cardstock to stamp those images. I find that alcohol markers work pretty well on that paper. Next step was to cut the interactive elements, so I taped the dies on my panels and sent them to my die-cut machine. Next, I folded the pocket panel in half, right on the score line, and I also folded the tabs on both sides. I also applied strong double-sided tape on those tabs, on the front and at the back. I removed the backing paper at the back and folded the tabs. Next, I applied a whole lot of powder at the back of my panels, on the flaps and along the tabs, and I also used my bone folder to rub the edges and make them softer. Doing this really helps to get a smooth mechanism. Next, I put the moving panel inside the pocket panel into the slot and put each little flap into a slot like so. I pulled the tab to interlock everything. I made sure that the moving panel was sitting straight between the tabs. I removed the backing paper and closed the pocket panel to complete the interactive part of my card. Next, I wanted the magic picture changer element to go in the center of my card, so I placed the frame die with the notch at the top, right in the middle of my green panel to cut a frame out of it. I attached that frame on the pocket using double-sided tape on the four edges. And next, I started to assemble my little scene on a green card base. So I wasn't going to need the bottom of my green panel, so I cut it off. And next, I attached the remaining pieces of background using foam tape, as well as the interactive pocket using double-sided tape. Off-screen, I cut two wavy borders to ground my scene and attach those pieces at the bottom of my panel. And next, I moved on to my favorite part. I assembled and stuck all my cute images to finally create the scene I had in mind. The final steps were to stamp my sentiment, magical wishes at the bottom, and to add a handle at the top of the pull tab. And that's it, a lovely little scene in an enchanted forest that I hope you like. Now to the frog card and let's check out the supplies. Feeling froggy, savannah safari for some tiny rocks, penguin pals for two small fishes, spring scenes for the trees and mountains, and best fishes for some seaweeds. I started by stamping my images on 80-pound Nina Solar Watt cardstock using Memento Tuxedo Black ink, and I colored them using my alcohol markers like always. Next, I cut all my background elements out of Strathmore Bristol cardstock, a 5.5 by 4.25 inches panel, a wavy border, a grass border, and a hill border. Started with the rectangle panel to create a cloudy sky using a cloud stencil along with tumble glass distress ink. Next, I turned the hill border into a pond using tumble glass and peacock feathers distress inks. And I used antique linen with a little bit of Raid Burlap distress inks to color the top of the grass border. And finally, I used shabby shutters and modeling distress inks to turn the wavy border into a grass border. Next, I assembled all my elements on my cloudy panel, starting with the borders, and next, all the images. Once everything was attached, I stamped my sentiment at the top of my panel and then created some Morning Dew Nouveau drops here and there for a little bit of shine. And that's it, all done! a lovely and quiet time at the pond with this cute little frog sitting on a water lily leaf. So here are my projects. I had a lot of fun creating them. Thank you so much, Sunny Studio, for inviting me. And thank you guys for watching. I hope you enjoyed this video. See you very soon. Bye!